take me now! Free brunch!
People's Tribune Radio is brought to you by People's Tribune Newspaper, a monthly published in Chicago. Please listen.
People's Tribune, December 2016, page 12. A great read, The Soldier of Truth, The Trials of Reverend Edward Pinkney. Editor's note, Phillip A. Bassett's new book, Soldier of Truth, is about the author's eyewitness account of the persecution of Reverend Edward Pinkney for his leadership in a fight against the takeover of a town by a corporate giant. You can purchase the book on Amazon.com. To review this book, first we have Latoya Williams, who says, "This book gave me a new perspective on what my stepfather has been called by God to do. It gave me insight on what was done, what was said, some insight on what happened in court. It also gave me insight on what happened when he first heard the voice of God. He truly has a purpose, and it is bigger than Benton Harbor, Michigan. He's truly a fighter, and has always stood up for what was right. Many people said negative things, but if these same people were to walk in his shoes and do what he's done and continues to do, they would not last an hour, much less a day. But I stand to say I am truly proud of him and all that he has accomplished and continues to accomplish. A real soldier is what he is to me. Good job, Phillip Bassett. This is a great read. Latoya Williams." And the editor's note, at the very heart of the story is the Whirlpool Corporation, a shaker and mover behind the courts, the police, and the prosecution. Whirlpool, with its corporate headquarters in Benton Harbor, is in complete control of the economic and political life. Whirlpool's use of the state's emergency manager dictator laws to steal Benton Harbor's assets from the jobless, impoverished town, especially the Gene Clock Park, which sits on the lakefront, in order to gentrify the town, explains their need to quiet all opposition, especially Reverend Pinkney. However, even in prison, Reverend Pinkney would not remain quiet. Within a week of arriving at a Michigan prison, he organized more than two-thirds of the prison inmates in an action against buck-naked fish, the smelliest, worst item on the menu of a generally bad food served there. What was remarkable was that the unity was forged across religious, ethnic, and color lines among inmates who normally would be at each other's throats. Events from Reverend Pinkney's youth that helped mold him as a leader are also covered in the book, much of it in Reverend Pinkney's own words. The editors of the People's Tribune state, "Because of his importance to the fight against corporate control of government, the People's Tribune has been reporting on Benton Harbor and its struggles since 2005. And Reverend Pinkney has filed articles for the People's Tribune for the past 10 years. Next up is a special interview with Phillip Bassett, author of Soldier of Truth.
I'm just a regular guy. I don't have an agenda to push. Why did I write the book? What motivated me? Because it was such a grave injustice. I think that what I was trying to do is to give my account as a witness of something that I saw. I saw a man who many would see as not only just a good man, but a very good man. One of the best men, because he's brave, he's kind, he's willing to help other people at the drop of a hat. And to see this man have one of the worst punishments possible in our civilized society, it kind of, I think it broke something in me. And it became almost an obsession, because I saw this man who was a hero in my eyes, and he's being treated so badly by this system. you know, it makes sense to me because everywhere you look, everything is upside down, you know. And you tell a lot of people about it, and a lot of people aren't surprised at all about these events that happen. Another thing was the arrogance of the court. They went through their motions so casually. It's like they so casually break the law and do things that seem really immoral in my mind. So you could say it's the genesis of two men, because it talks about my experience and how I've changed as well. Now, he would be the first to say that this is not about him, and I agree, because he is a symbol of what's wrong in America. And I think the reason that I focused on him and has so much to offer in a positive way, and to see him be crushed by this heartless system, I wrote the book because I've witnessed three trials. I have seen the actions of the judges, the attorneys. I've seen the arguments of the attorneys in the first voter fraud trial, which was a complete, it was smoke and mirrors. They were deceiving the jury. There was so much deception and inference going on with no attempt to prove anything, really, in the first trial, that it quickly convinced me that this is my opinion, that it's a cesspool of corruption. I grew up thinking that the system was fair. This was my first real experience with a legal system that it turned something in me, that it made me angry. And I suppose that was the motivation for the book. It's not a journalistic endeavor. There's a little bit of Reverend Pinkney's childhood background, just to explain where he's coming from. And then right away, the book starts going into his political stands very early on. And then talking about his experience in jail, career, you might say, goes into the second trial quite a bit, includes some court transcripts, so that people can see exactly what does go on in a courtroom. And then talks about his break with the NAACP. And then finally, we talk a little bit about the last trial for forgery, when he was accused of forgery for five dates that were, you know, supposedly changed on petitions. I think of it as kind of a potpourri or a hodgepodge. Every chapter is different and has a different focus. Chapter 7 is all court transcripts. Chapter 8 is mostly the Reverend speaking about his prison experience. Makes use of, you might call, flashback. It finally comes full circle when we get to about the 7th chapter. It does go through in a very natural progression how Reverend Pinkney was brought to do what he did. And he has been forced into many of his actions over time by these court cases being brought against him. This has become, in a way, his activism. It's been shoved upon him. In the afterword, I told people that his situation is precarious and dangerous.
You can get a copy of Soldier of Truth from Amazon.com or order it from your bookstore. Ask your library to get a copy of Soldier of Truth.
Contact the People's Tribune at www.peoplestribune.org or call 1-800-691-6888. The only solution to our problems is a cooperative society where the needs of all the people are met. Subscribe to the People's Tribune and order copies to share with your friends. Donate at peoplestribune.org. We need your support to continue telling the truth. Find PTR, People's Tribune Radio, at iTunes and YouTube, and subscribe. People's Tribune pages are open to you. Tell us your story. Let's discuss the steps we can take now to get to that new society. Find out how people are fighting forward with a vision.